The Legendary Life of Margaret Burke White.
Warning, this video contains graphic and disturbing images. Viewer discretion is strongly advised.
Margaret Burke White, a pioneering female photojournalist, used photography to document some of the most spectacular objects, people, and moments that shaped the 20th century. She captured influential world leaders as well as overlooked and impoverished citizens across the globe. Tirelessly and fearlessly, Margaret revealed human suffering and injustice while simultaneously expanding the field of photojournalism for women and photographers today. Dining with dictators, flying on bombing missions, and photographing the front lines of war, Margaret traveled the world, opening up the frontier of opportunity for female photographers.
Margaret Burke White grew up in a post-World War I world. The idea of a new woman had spread throughout the country, symbolized by short bob hairstyle, cigarettes, and jazz music. This movement challenged traditional gender roles and societal norms. Women became more independent, confident, and empowered. Women adapted to wartime, and many picked up what was referred to as women's jobs to provide for their families. Photography entered a period of modernization, opening up the world of art for women. It was accessible, allowing women to establish private studios and learn the principles of photography within a supportive community of other women.
Margaret started her photography career working freelance, receiving her first big break photographing a school. This allowed her to open up a commercial photography studio out of her apartment. Margaret focused on capturing the urban growth and technological advancements of the machine age. This period marked a frontier in urbanization and infrastructure. While cities were expanding, labor was needed to support the growth of industry. Margaret brought the realities of pollution, overcrowding, and poverty to light that came with this rapid development.
While working for Fortune, Margaret became the first Western photographer, male or female, who crossed the political frontier into Russia. She sent multiple requests and used her various connections to eventually be granted access to photograph there. Showing off Margaret's determination and capabilities to navigate the political landscape, she photographed the Soviet industry during Stalin's five-year plan, which was designed to create rapid industrialization. However, her dedication to photography led to her being seen as bothersome in the professional world. Critics viewed her work in Russia as propaganda and called Life magazine the peeping Tom of American journalism.
Most people didn't know her. They knew of her. Being a woman in a man's world, you're overbearing, you're dominating, you're a career climber, when really you're just doing what all the guys are doing.
As a result of her persistence, she returned to the Soviet Union to document the changes three times from 1930 to 1932. By then, she had become one of the most well-known photographers in the United States.
Margaret focused on industrial photography. However, when Fortune sent her to cover the conditions of the drought in the Midwest, Margaret experienced a key turning point. For the first time, she interacted with the farmers and families, trying to capture their lives and tragedies. She became interested in documentary photography, allowing her to expose social justice issues instead of her usual industrial style.
By 1930, photography started to attain popularity and recognition, with accessible and lightweight cameras making it easier to capture photographs anywhere. Before television, photography was an important format for sharing significant events and spreading awareness to the world. Mr. Luce of Fortune magazine was able to build upon the fast-paced American lifestyle with what he called picture magic. He hired Margaret for his new magazine titled Life, that would give photographs a spotlight over words. Margaret was the first female photographer hired for the magazine. In 1936, the first issue of Life magazine was published, with one of her photographs on the cover.
She was the first woman photojournalist to attract any attention, and that was partly because photojournalism was so new. In some ways, Life magazine invented that.
When World War II broke out, September 1st, 1939, Life magazine immediately sent Margaret to Europe. As the first German bombs fell on Moscow in 1941, Margaret was there to capture it all. She spent 22 nights risking her life to photograph Russia during air raids. When the U.S. entered the war in 1941, Margaret was accredited to the U.S. Army Air Force and became the first female war correspondent and the first woman to photograph a bombing mission. While traveling along the coast of North Africa, Margaret's ship came under torpedo attack. She was able to escape on a lifeboat while capturing the experience on the one camera she managed to save.
When we reached North Africa, General Doolittle said, "Maggie, do you still want to go on a bombing mission?" He said, "Well, you've been torpedoed, you might as well go through everything."
In 1943, Margaret documented the war in Italy from the ground. where she was exposed to the human side of war. This was the most dangerous and frightening period of her career. Unfortunately, the majority of her photos were lost.
In March of 1945, Margaret traveled through Germany, photographing some of the most horrifying scenes of World War II and sharing them with the world. Margaret said she barely recognized the country she traveled to years earlier, as all of the cities were now destroyed. She arrived at Buchenwald just 2 hours after the Nazis fled. Her photos of the emaciated inmates stunned the world, and the image, the living dead of Buchenwald, became one of the most significant images of the 20th century. Margaret used her camera to shield herself from the terror she was photographing. This was especially important as she worked photographing victims of the Holocaust due to her Jewish heritage.
In 1947, after the war, Margaret spent over 2 years in India documenting the struggle between Muslims and Hindus. She photographed the father of the modern Buddhist movement, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, and Mahatma Gandhi 2 hours before his assassination. She was one of the most effective chroniclers of the violence at the partition of India and Pakistan, capturing the human cost of the conflict. This was a political and social frontier as it marked the end of the British colonial rule in South Asia, but also a physical frontier that separated British India into two independent nations. This led to a massive migration and population shift across religious barriers. Margaret then spent 5 months in South Africa studying the racial conflict and life under apartheid. After that, Margaret traveled to Korea, spending 9 months there to report on the Korean War.
After noticing an ache in her arms and legs in 1952, Margaret traveled back to the U.S. and was diagnosed with Parkinson's disease at just 49 years old. Utilizing the platform she built, Margaret shared the reality of her struggle with Parkinson's. She was one of the first people to open up about her journey, normalizing a disease that affects approximately 500,000 Americans today.
I mean, we're grateful for the folks who were pioneers at that time because they really crawled so we could start this sprint.
She continued to work for as long as she could, eventually retiring in 1969 at the age of 65. 2 years later, on August 27, 1971, Margaret Burke White died in Stamford, Connecticut.
She was just such a determined person, both professionally with her photography and the fact she traveled the world and really documented these sort of seminal moments of the 20th century.
Margaret was able to develop the photographic essay, which increased the impact photography had on society. Margaret wasn't focused on taking a pretty picture. She wanted to bring the harsh realities home to people around the world. Putting a face to tragedies and injustices, Margaret shared the stories of overlooked citizens. She helped break down stereotypes and humanize people through her photographs, while also contributing to a record of the past, allowing mistakes to be learned from. Her work had the power to spark conversations and inspire action, but did not single-handedly eradicate the social, political, and economic challenges faced by society today.
With her determination and talent, Margaret showed that photographers could be strong and brave women who challenged the frontiers of the industry. Margaret didn't have other female photographers to look up to, but she became that role model for others. She inspires women to challenge the limitations imposed on them and break through frontiers.
Margaret's photographs not only spread awareness of injustices across the globe, they ignited empathy in viewers. She used photography as a medium to capture the essence of human existence and bridge the gaps between different cultures and society. Margaret Burke White's remarkable ability to navigate the frontiers of her profession, coupled with her unwavering commitment to capturing the human experience, continues to inspire photographers and storytellers alike, reminding people today of the transformative power of images and their ability to shape our understanding of the world.
Margaret Burke White was a woman of firsts. She was the first photographer for Fortune magazine and the first photographer authorized to enter the Soviet Union. She was the first female photographer for Life magazine, and her photograph is on the first cover. She was the first female photographer to work with the U.S. Armed Forces, accompany a bombing mission, and work in combat zones during World War II. Because of her pioneering work, Margaret was able to shine a light on the injustices of the world and challenge a frontier for female photographers. Margaret Burke White was a trailblazer in her field, crossing physical and idealistic frontiers.